When you're buying a house, there's always going to be something wrong with it, no matter if it's new or old. Some things turn up in the building report and other things turn up as you find out how it operates, how it functions, as you live with it. And that's what today's video is about. We're going to talk about everything that we've done to the house so far. So first on the list of things that we've already done to the house, even though I've only been here for a couple months, is in the master bedroom. When we first got here, in the bay window, only one of the windows worked, and it was the one on the right here. The other two, the mechanisms that actually hold up the sashes themselves, didn't work. We replaced those soon after, so now they actually do hold themselves up. Before, you would just sort of put them up and they'd fall straight back down, which wasn't really great over the summer, but obviously we got through it. But now these actually work properly. One thing we already have worked on in the workshop area is these screens here. So all underneath here, there are ventilation holes, as you can see, which is great. It lets a bit of a draft in and sort of helps to deter white ants from coming in because there's a nice breeze and it's never damp under here. But it did also mean there was a lot of cockroaches and things like that getting in. When we first moved in, there was heaps of cockroaches. So we made up these, what is basically fly screens. We got some recycled frames of old fly screens and put these in here. These are sikaflexed in, so they're not going anywhere. And they are pretty much all throughout underneath here. Just as a simple sort of reno job to the house that would help keep the bugs out from inside. Because then obviously they could climb up in between the walls and all that sort of stuff from just getting in through here. So one thing that did turn up in the building report when we were looking to buy this house was there was a roof tile just about over there that was loose and out of place for some reason. Pretty much within the first couple of weeks, my dad and I put up this bricky scaffolding to get up there and put it back into place. That meant also putting in the mortar on the ends just about there, just to keep it all in place. And since then, we've also had another tile move out of place. Thankfully, no water got inside the house, and if it did, it was sort of over the eaves there. It is a bit of a worry for us looking forward. We've had some quotes to get it fixed and things like that, but that's going to be pretty expensive to do, as most sort of things to do with roofs are. But we're just keeping an eye on it for the moment. Like, the tiles are a little bit loose and it gets really windy up here, especially on the ridge, so it is a concern, but for the moment we're just going to keep an eye on it. When we first got the house, the pool was not compliant, so it was sold with a not compliant certificate. And in New South Wales at least, you need to have the pool made compliant within 3 months of it being purchased. So there was a couple of things, like some of the posts had rusted, which meant they weren't stable anymore, and a couple of things. But the main thing was that the pool pump and all its paraphernalia was too close to the pool fence, meaning that you could jump on it and then jump over the fence. And as you can see, it used to be right there. So over a couple of weekends, my dad and I, we replumbed it and moved it from this area here all the way up into this corner here. So it's a lot sort of neater. And then soon after, we got our compliance certificate. So that is all good. So right now we're down one of the sides of the house. And this is actually somewhere where, as you can tell, we've recently done some of the first renovations. Before, the front downpipe just there, and this other one that's in this corner as well, you can see just down there, they basically just went straight into the ground. And that meant when there was a lot of rain, it seeped through the walls and into the garage, which is just this wall just here. And also down on this part of the wall is obviously into the rumpus room. And obviously water is the enemy of any house. So one of the first things we did was dig up a trench that goes all the way along the length of this down to the foundation. We painted it with a tar paint or a waterproof paint. It's that black paint there you can see on the bricks. And then we put in some geotextile, some gravel, and then some ag drain, which is this stuff in the corner here. And then we also connected this downpipe there and ran a pipe all the way down. So underneath that dirt there is all of that. And this all heads down into this pit here. Now, the purpose of this was mostly just to get the water all to go into one place. This meant that it sort of was getting it away from the walls and it was all collecting here. And from there, it's just gonna bubble up and sort of head out over the rest of the yard, which it kind of did before, but not in this sort of concentrated way. And then from there, we can always take it down into a rainwater tank or something like that. But it's a lot better than having it spill over the grass here than having it up against the walls. So that concludes the second video of this series, going through everything that we've done to this house already. It's only been a couple of months, but as you can kind of see, the main things that we've worked on so far are the major things that are crucial that are done, things like plumbing and that kind of thing, just to make sure the house is functional. We haven't really done anything that's aesthetic so much yet, but that's still to come. And in the next video, you'll see everything that we have planned to do on the house. So make sure you subscribe to this YouTube channel to keep up to date with everything that's going on, and I'll see you in the next one.